It's time now for latest in local sports and sports. The NCAA college football playoffs kick off tomorrow with two semifinal games. First to be played out in Tempe, Arizona, features number 2 Michigan and number 3 TCU. Horned Frogs all season long have found a way to win, while Michigan went to Columbus and whipped up on Ohio State for the second year in a row. Michigan in the playoffs last year, beaten by Georgia down in Miami. Oddsmakers like Michigan, but this is the episode of the weekend. I like the Horned Frogs. I think their team speed will give Michigan problems. We got TCU shocking the college football world tomorrow. TCU wins Saturday afternoon. In game 2, it's the Peach Bowl. Georgia hosting number 4 Ohio State. Buckeyes trying to redeem themselves after being embarrassed at home by Michigan. The debate was whether they even deserved to be in the playoff picture. They basically got in by default as everyone else had 2 losses, while Ohio State only had that 1 loss to Michigan. But it just wasn't a loss. It was a beat down at home. Wolverines have NFL talent. The Buckeyes have NFL talent. Harrison Kidd definitely a number 1 pick in the draft. But the Dogs are basically home at the Mercedes-Benz where they played twice already. One big both times, whipping up on Oregon to start the season in week 1 and putting 50 points on LSU in the SEC title game. It's Stetson Bennett and the Dogs are rolling this game. Kirby Smart and Will Muschamp will have the defense ready to shut down that offensive passing attack of Ohio State, just like they shut down Tennessee's passing attack in Athens. I've got George winning this game 35-13. It's on to Miami to play the Horned Frogs of TCU. Mailman delivers once again. Offense coordinator Todd Monken had the latest interview at the press conference, was asked about Stetson Bennett, and Todd Monken simply stated, quote, "We simply want to be where we are without him," end quote. So again, Georgia wins this game Saturday. Ready to watch this game in person. Again, thanks, Santa. Can't thank you enough for the gift. Much appreciated. Georgia and Atlanta Saturday night to beat up on Ohio State at the Mercedes-Benz Stadium. Bowl mania continues today. 3 more bowl games played yesterday. Minnesota over Syracuse in the Pinstripe Bowl in New York. Final score 28-20. FSU defeated Oklahoma last night in a pretty good ball game. The Cheez-It Bowl 35-32. FSU wins it. And Washington over Texas in the Alamo Bowl. Final score Washington 27, Texas 20. More bowl action today. 5 games on tap today. Gets underway at the Mayo Bowl at 12 noon. NC State of Maryland. In the Sun Bowl at 2 p.m., UCLA in Pittsburgh. Gator Bowl in Jacksonville takes place today at 3:30. Pretty good game between South Carolina and Notre Dame. In the Arizona Bowl, Ohio and Wyoming at 4:30. It all concludes tonight with the Orange Bowl. It's Tennessee and Clemson. There'll be a lot of orange there as both Tennessee and Clemson wear orange uniforms. So, again, 5 games on tap for today. Then the 2 playoff games tomorrow. NFL football last night, Cowboys 27-13 over the Titans. Sunday, the Jaguars at Houston at 1 p.m. Again, Jaguars still have the chance to win the division, already settling playoff tickets and hoping to host that first-round playoff game at home. Falcons will be at home tomorrow taking on Arizona. That also a 1 p.m. kickoff. Finally in sports, Pelé died yesterday at the age of 82. He won 3 World Cups, became one of the most known figures in sports over the past century. He'd undergone treatment for colon cancer since 2021, had been in the hospital over the past month. Funeral was set for Monday. The Brazilian president has declared 3 days of mourning in that country in honor of the soccer star. And Pelé, regarded as the greatest soccer player in history, died yesterday at the age of 82. That's going to do it for the latest in local sports.